Welcome back to Learn with Latisha. So today we are gonna do the Revati's musical planks. We have already done the half part of this chapter before only, but now we are gonna complete the remaining half. So let's begin.
Hi everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to do Revati's musical plan. That lesson we had done only part 1. Now this is part 2. In this we are going to do the further part. So till now let us revise what we have done. In that part 1 we had done that Revati was a lover of music. She used to play violin. And in her courtyard there was a balsam plant which was not getting proper sunlight, due to which the growth of that plant was stunted. So she had removed that plant and kept it in such a way that it was able to get enough sunlight. Okay, and that was her daily routine. She used to sit on the bench in the courtyard and she used to play the violin. And while playing the violin, she observed one thing, that the plants were getting the movement. Means they were moving. They were enjoying the music which Revati used to play. So there was a bond between Revati and the plant. Revati's grief knew no bounds. She was very sad, and that sadness had no limits. Like you all also do know, like if anything favorite of yours is lost or you have lost it, you don't find it, then you feel very sad about it. So she was also very, very sad. She went around asking every one of her neighbors, but no one had been anywhere near the pot of plants. She could not lodge a complaint for a pot of plants. Yes, she could not go to a police and say that I have lost a pot, so please search. The policeman will laugh at her. He will say, what a girl you are, you have came for a silly plant. She felt as though everything was lost. She felt like everything was lost for her. She did not mind not getting the prize, but she really missed her plants. She had grown very fond of her. She was very fond of them. Means like she used to sit every day in the courtyard and play the violin for the plants, and plants were also enjoying that music. So there was a bond between the plant and Revati. They had created a bond among themselves, like a bond of friendship, you can say. They were her friends who enjoyed her music. So I said, you all, like they were like her friends to her. And when we don't meet our friends, we feel very sad, isn't it? So Revati was also feeling the same. She was missing her friends very much. That evening, all her friends were going to prize distribution ceremony. She did not want to attend, but her friends forced her to. After reaching the place, she went to the benches where the pot plants were displayed. Revati was shocked. There was a pot of plant on a bench with the name of a distant neighbor of hers as the competitor written on a small piece of cardboard and placed it in the soil. She knew it was a pot of plants. She went to the organizers of the show and told them about it. Now, that evening, the prize distribution, there was a competition in her society, so she had to go. But she was not in a mood to go. All her friends came to her and forced her that, come on, your mood will be nice when you come up, come down, so let's go. So they forced her and she had to go. And when she went there, what she saw, she was shocked. Why? Because there was a plant placed on the table with a different name. Whose name? A neighbor who was staying very far distance, means very far from her house. She saw that her name was there on that plant, on that pot. She was shocked. How can that plant go to her house? And she recognized that plant very well. So she was not mistaken also. So let's see what. The organizers were not convinced. They said, how can you prove that the plants are yours? The lady who submitted them is a regular participant. How can we doubt her? Now, Revati went to the organizers of the competition and requested them that this plant belongs to me. It is not of that person who has written the name of that, written the name on that pot. But now the organizers are not ready to convince, not ready to accept it. They said, how can you prove that? The lady who has taken part in the competition, we know them from many years and she is participating from many years. So how can we doubt her? And that's also true because there was no point in doubting. So Revati wondered how to convince them. She sat there for a few minutes looking at the plants. The sight of the plants bending towards her while she played her violin flashed across her mind. She told the organizers that she could prove the plants were hers. She ran home. When she returned a few minutes later with her violin in, they started laughing. Now what happened? Revati started, sat down sadly there and she was just thinking that how should I convince them? How should I convince him? Then she had a memory. She had an idea that, or she came to know what? That the plants responded to her violin and that too to the Raga Mohanam. So she ran at once and she came back with a violin in her hand and she told the organizers that I can prove it. But they were laughing at her. Why? Because they were thinking, with the violin, what is this girl going to do? Or how is she going to prove that the plant belongs to her? But the ridicule did not deter her from her mission. Means whatever fun they were making when they were laughing, she felt very disappointed. She was they were making fun of her. But she did not discourage herself, but she encouraged herself and went for a mission. She told them, I know my plants and I share a secret with them. My plants are music lovers like me and you could see how they respond when I play to them. They all laughed louder, saying that they had never heard of plants enjoying music. They asked her, do plants have ears like us to enjoy your music? No one believed her. Now as she said that I know my plants and I share a secret with them. My plants are music lover and they respond to my music. Now what they were thinking? They were laughing at her and they told her or asked her that do plants have ears to listen to your music or enjoy your music? Are you joking or are you kidding? She felt very dejected but was determined to win her plants back. She sat near her plants with a violin and slowly started playing her favorite raga. Engrossed in her music, Revati even forgot her plants for a time, but the others could not. With wonder in their eyes, they watched the plant. Straight at first, they bent slightly. As she played on and on, their stems bent towards Revati as though they wanted to touch her in their happiness. The organizers were stunned. They had watched a new phenomena of plants responding to music and Revati had become a great discoverer. Now she was disappointed when all were laughing, but she was determined that I want my plants back. If I win or not win, or if I win the competition or I don't win the competition, that doesn't mean anything to her. She only wanted her plant back. So she started playing her favorite raga, that is Mohanam. And she was so engrossed, means she was so lost in that music that she forgot she was sitting in the competition, she was sitting in front of the plant. There were many people looking around her. No, she forgot everything and she just closed her eyes and she was so engrossed in her music. She was playing the violin. And slowly what we saw, or what the others, audience saw, that the plant was first became straight and then slightly it was bending towards Revati, as though they wanted to touch her. And everyone thought that they were in happiness, they were swaying, they were slowly moving towards her. Now everyone was astonished, surprised. It was a surprise. If I would have been there, I would also be astonished to see these all things. So this was a wonder. You can say this was a miracle. Phenomena means a wonder or a miracle happening in front of us. So it was a great miracle. They all applauded her and said they were convinced that the plants were hers. Now all were convinced and they started applauding her, appreciating her, praising her. They pulled up her neighbor for cheating them, and she accepted after a long argument that she had stolen Revati's plant. Now they took hold of the lady who had stolen the plant and they asked her. And after a long argument means after a long debate, you can say, or fight, you can say, a small fight, she at last gave up and she said that she had stolen the plant from Revati's house last evening. She said, while walking past Revati's house, she had spotted the plants and had removed the pot in the night to her house and submitted it later for the contest. So she had stolen it night, and that she had submitted that plant for the contest. As she was a regular participant, no one doubted her. Of course, the authorities decided that Revati's plant deserved the first prize, as they were the best looking and healthy. Revati carried home the prize proudly with her pot of plants. So here we can see that at last she convinced the organizers. She was able to convince the organizers, and she was able to take her pot back to her house, and along with the prize also, she was feeling very proud at that moment. And yes, friends, so she was happy also, and everyone was happy to give her plant back to her. So that's all for today. I hope you all have enjoyed this story. You all have understood the lesson. Thank you, all of you. See you again in the next video.
Thank you. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel.